It has been way too long since I've reacted to my favorite band of all time, Lacuna Coil, brand new single in the meantime, and I think this is the very first time they've ever featured a guest vocalist, because this one features Ash Costello from the band New Year's Day. Highly compelling, I'm overjoyed to know that they've dropped new music, and I just want to dive in and check it out. But before I do, I'm Blake X, and this is Nuclear Reactions. If you're new around here, then don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you want to make a song request and make sure that it gets a reaction on this channel right away, check out my Patreon. That'll be linked down below in the description. If you joined here for on Patreon, that's how you get that special VIP treatment. All right, Lacuna Coil, in the meantime, featuring Ash Costello, and this includes the official music video. I gotta see these guys again, man. It's been too long. It's already been almost 2 years since I've seen them live. Last time I caught them in Pittsburgh, they were amazing as always, but I really got to catch a show. I just really have to make it happen. Anyway, we'll see what this is all about. I'm not sure if this is a standalone single or if it's meant to be the very first single from their upcoming new album. I know they've been working on the new album, so you guys can let me know in the comments if you know more. But without further ado, let's check this out. Oh, this is like a film quality video. Initial thoughts, just right off the bat. Andy is coming in with those harshes right away. It's cool that they maintain that. I like both sides of Lacuna Coil. I like when they do only the cleans with Christina and also with Andy singing and harmonizing with her. I think that's amazing. But also, Andy has really been excelling at his harshes, ever since Black Anima especially. It's just gotten better and better. We also hear Christina a little bit in the background. We'll see what she does with her cleans. She's always excellent. And quite an impressive quality for this music video so far. This is probably the highest quality video they've done at this point. Yeah, just some initial thoughts. Let's keep going. There it is. Lacuna Coil always does like really out of left field stuff with their vocal approaches. Like, for example, how Christina sang that part and the way she transitioned her voice from one part to the other, where she sang, "I don't know how to reset myself," the way she sang "myself," that was just so cool. It's like, it just sounded very atypical. It wasn't the kind of cadence that you come to expect from like an average clean chorus part of a song. So I just think that's cool the way that she did that. A lot of like nice little nuances, and that was one of them. Just wanted to point that out. I like that deep roar again. I love what she does right there. Oh, chills. That's cool. I was wondering when Ash Costello, when her vocals were going to kick in. Now, for those who don't know, I'm not really familiar with New Year's Day. Maybe that's a band I need to explore and check out more of. Let me know in the comments if that's something you want to see me react to. I could definitely do that. I didn't know how her vocal part was going to kick in, and it's so cool that she's harmonizing with Christina here. you don't usually hear a lot of female singers do that in metal. Usually it's like a Beauty and the Beast thing. Either the male does the harshes and the woman harmonizes with her cleans, or both people use their cleans, the guy and the woman, and they both harmonize regardless. But you don't often hear two clean female vocalists in harmony with one another. So to hear these two voices in tandem, and they are very different, so you could hear each respective part, neither voice is seeming to cancel out the other one. So it's a really nice harmony so far. That's cool. I hope it's not over yet. Please don't be over. Oh, that's so nice. So well-rounded, too. Everything just fits and works. Reset. Restart. That fade out with the fire and the crows there, that's cool. That was a cool little thing there. They didn't have to add that in at the end, that little, the crackling of the fire and the crows or ravens. I like those subtle little additions, you know? It's like things that you don't feel are necessary, perhaps, but when they're in there, they contribute something atmospherically to the music. I absolutely love this, as you can well imagine. But to the degree that I loved it, I'm pleasantly surprised, because here's why. When Black Anima came out, that was my absolute favorite record that they had ever done, and still is. It's, to me, it was and continues to be their masterpiece. It's unfortunate that it was released at a time when there was so much crazy shit happening in the world. There was so much turmoil. So I feel like that put a damper on its ability to really shine, to really get the attention and love that it deserved. On a more widespread scale. Like, obviously, all the Lacuna Coil fans were thrilled with it. I haven't met any fellow Coilers who don't love that record. But I'm just more or less speaking to the greater public sphere in terms of people who consume music. I wish that more people... I'll put it this way. I wish that that album had ended up on the radar for more metal and music listeners in general. But it did very well, despite that. And... to this day, I think that's the best that they've ever done. And so after that record came out, I was very concerned about how or if they were going to be able to really top that record in terms of quality. I don't know if they can, and that is not saying anything negative about the band, because I think that the band is getting better and better and better with every new album they put out there. They're just fantastic. But because that album was so good, and because it's so special to me and I love it so much, I wasn't sure how I would feel about more new music after that. Now, obviously, I loved the reworking of Coma Lies. They really got creative with how they did a sort of remakes or reboots of their old tracks off of that original record. So when that came out, that was cool. It wasn't up there, you know, with Black Anima for me, but it was still a really cool record, and I enjoyed listening to it. But as for this one, I won't say that I love it better than Black Anima, but I will say that I love it regardless, and it was really, really cool. They nailed all their parts. The drumming was really good on this as well. I don't think I pointed it out when I was listening, but the way that it complemented Andy's harshes, that was really cool. Guitar is always on point. And again, what Christina chose to do with her cleans and the places that she took certain words that she sang, it was not the usual formulaic approach that you would come to expect when you hear a female vocalist singing in a metal band. And Christina has done that time and again. She's consistently been impressive with how she sings in these songs, and this was no different. So I was thoroughly impressed by that. It's just so good to hear these guys back again. I liked Ash Costello's vocals, so maybe I will give New Year's Day a chance. I was talking with my girlfriend a few weeks ago about the band New Year's Day, mentioning that I had remembered hearing them years ago, but I didn't quite recall if they really left an impression on me. Maybe I didn't properly pay attention to them at the time. So that might be a band worth exploring on this channel. Definitely let me know. As for this band itself, they just killed it. It was fantastic. I like that they had the budget to do a really quality movie-like music video. It was really good quality. I like all that fire and lava. There's probably a lot of symbolism in here that will maybe be explained later by the band or be explained better when the full record comes out. So maybe that's beyond what I'm able to get into in this video, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Musically, I just loved it. They're back. They're just back. I do have the lyrics pulled up here, so we will get into what this song may be talking about. Let's read them off and see what we can see. The scar and the hurt, the dream and the blood. We are locked up inside and the sickness of our time. We are losing control. Now it's hard to let it go. It feels like dying on the floor, waking up in pain. We are alone together. No one belongs. In the meantime, I'm falling down. I don't know how to reset myself. I'm still stuck inside my mind. I cannot breathe anymore. We lived through things I cannot say. I feel the cold when you twist the blade. So deep in the cuts. We are blood. We are hurt. We are the forsaken. We're living in vain as we die inside. Did they ever tell you to be stronger? Did they ever force you to be fine? There is something that they'll never understand. Everything cannot be aligned. When you lost the way and you fear yourself, when the pain never lets you go, it's hard to push yourself. Through another day, nothing kills you like your own twisted mind. I can't compete anymore. Nothing kills you like your own twisted mind. That's true. That's true, man. Okay, so before I even saw the lyrics, I was almost positive that the song title had a double meaning, and the message implicit in that title is well stated. You know, in the meantime, we have to be strong even as we suffer in darkness and despair. In the worst of times, we still have to struggle to survive. And, you know, Lacuna Coil was one of the bands that didn't compose new material during the lockdown in 2020. And I have to wonder if part of this, what's being spoken about in the song, part of it is also them sort of looking back and reflecting on those times years ago and how it affected everyone, because they didn't have the chance to talk about it then. Just how it affected people emotionally, psychologically, spiritually, if you believe in that. Because it mentions that we are locked up inside in the sickness of our time. And then later it says, we are alone together. No one belongs. So it could be referencing that, for sure, but it could also be applying that in a more generalized context, right? Because it's plain to see that a lot of people today feel lost and without a sense of happiness or fulfillment. And there are so many different factors in why that's the case that it would take more than a single video to break it all down, to explore all that. But the bottom line is that many people feel like we are living in particularly dark and chaotic times right now. And even if what happened in 2020 isn't the main point of this message, what happened during that year still certainly got the ball rolling on the hard times for people. Like, if you could point to any year where shit really hit the fan, I would say 2020. But it's also just one of many contributing factors. You know, there's also a lot of civil unrest happening in the world, not just in the U.S., but in the world. Devastating wars, some of which are unprecedented. And, you know, I won't get into specifics. You guys can pay attention to the news and see for yourselves. Everyone knows, but, you know, and to that point, if these lyrics are tapping into any of that, it's actually kind of refreshing that they don't go into detail on those things. but instead they take more of a bird's eye view approach, if you understand what I mean by that. Like, they look at it all on a large scale, like not with any biases, not with any particular social or political points of view or anything like that. They don't get into that stuff. That's not the kind of band Lacuna Coil is, and I love that about them, by the way. So they look at, sort of looking at it at a, on a really grander scale. Like, how is this affecting human life in general? And then they relate it back to the individual. So it's not so much complaining or preaching about anything as it is just taking a look at all of that and coming to the general conclusion that these are painful and difficult times for the individual person, which makes the writing here very human, which is something that Lacuna Coil are always good at doing. They're so gifted in terms of how down to earth and how they convey their empathy with other people. And you see that when you meet them or when you talk to them. They're just such nice, warm people. It's a really cool experience when you get to talk with them, hang out with them for a few minutes. You see that fully on display, and you also hear it and you feel it in their music. And that's a great, really enriching quality to have. I'm falling down. I don't know how to reset myself. I'm still stuck inside my mind. I can't compete anymore. It's this ongoing battle, this uphill struggle that many of us feel that we can't win. Or we can't even participate anymore because we feel so utterly defeated. It's a nice glimpse into the human pain of modern times. And it doesn't delve too much more deeply other than that, but I think it works, and that the emotion is on display, and that's what's important. The emotion is very clear and very palpable, not just in the writing, but also in the music that accompanies it. And the music was fantastic. I loved it. I loved every moment of it. Andy's vocals, I continuously feel that they're improving. It started with Black Anima, and I think he's just gotten even better since then. He took it like a kind of deep at certain parts of the song. He did a bit of a roar at one moment there. That was really cool. And Christina's voice, if I had any little criticism, I just wish that Christina, and I'm forgetting her name now, I'm sorry, Ash Costello, the vocalist from New Year's Day, if Christina and Ash had maybe even a little bit more time in the song to do their singing parts and to maybe even do different things with their singing parts, like maybe if the song was like a minute longer or something, I don't know. It's just that I like those parts so much. I could have done with even more of that, but regardless, this was just an excellent song. I'm excited for the new album, as everyone should be. So that's how I feel about this one. I'm going to wrap it up here. Much love to the guys in Lacuna Coil. You're killing it. And more content is on the way soon. Once again, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to check out my Patreon, linked in the description below. Tier 4, that's how you make a song request and make sure that it gets a reaction right away. Much love and respect to the Nuclear family, and I will catch you all next time.